Look at the objects around you. That cap on your soda bottle. The spare change on the table. The rubber ducky in your bathtub. These objects and more aren't what they seem. Well, actually not the rubber ducky, but the others have some secret uses you won't see coming. Pots and pans. Yeah, you can drum on them, but I'm talking about that hole in the handle. It's not just for hanging your cookware up on the wall to save some space. You can also put a wooden spoon in that hole to keep it from messing your stove and countertops. Wooden hangers aren't just comfier and fancier than their plastic and metal counterparts. They also repel bugs and moths that like to munch on your clothes. Next time you're shopping for some hangers, go for ones made of cedar. That's the secret. That hole in the top of the lollipop stick isn't the manufacturer's nice way of giving you a whistle. It holds the candy in place. The lolly starts out as a liquid, so it flows into the holes. Once it hardens, it's locked in place for your convenience. The blue side of an eraser isn't meant to erase pen ink. It's supposed to be for thicker and rougher kinds of paper. It still gets the job done with pens, but remember this other intended purpose the next time you try to use it on thin paper. That's why it tears. Ever notice the soft round part under a soda cap bottle? Looks kind of like a big thick contact lens. While the cap itself is enough to keep the liquid inside the bottle, the soft part keeps the carbonation from escaping. Without it, your pop would go flat in no time, probably before you even buy it. Now, let's check out the cap on a small tube. Some are hollow on top and have a little spike in them. If you ever wondered why it's there, it's to break the foil sticker sealing the tube. The neck fits right in this hole, and the spike is designed to break the seal. No need to struggle trying to tear the tiny foil seal off with your fingers. The headrest in your car. You can adjust it along those metal poles, depending on your height, and that's all good and fun. But the headrests are also fully detachable, which begs the question, why? Well, you can also use those metal legs to break the window in case of an emergency and you're trapped in the car. Post-it notes are your most trusted reminders, but they're also handy when cleaning. If you ran out of wet wipes for your laptop, or you don't feel like getting up and fetching them, just stick a post-it note to a messy place on the keyboard and pull it off. Repeat several times and enjoy crumb-free keys again. Just make sure the laptop is off while you do this. Now, picture this. You're on a camping trip, and you've got a splinter in your finger. Of course, you didn't pack tweezers because, well, who would? If you have some spare change on you, then you can make your own tweezers. Just make a stack of three and push the middle one out of the stack about halfway. Now, you can pinch the other two coins together, and they'll grab something small with pinpoint accuracy. There you go, no more splinter. Or a stray nose hair hanging out while you're on a date. I hate when that happens. Or let's say your knife is dull and you forgot to pack a sharpener on that camping trip. What to do? Just flip a ceramic coffee cup upside down and you have a perfect whetstone. The bottom rim of most mugs isn't smooth and glossy like the rest of the cup. Sliding the blade against this gritty surface will sharpen the knife easily. Did you at least bring some floss? If so, then you won't need a knife if you're cutting into something soft like butter. Dental floss will do. Bonus tip, you can also cut the end of your chapstick off with some floss, just in case you dropped it on the ground with the cap off and it got all dirty. Or you shared it with a friend and you're a tad germaphobic. Ew, don't touch me. Here's one for all the pet parents out there. Your furniture is covered in cat or dog fur, and you've just about broken the bank on lint rollers. Grab a pair of rubber gloves. They're surprisingly good at picking up pet hair off armchairs and sofas. Many people think that the hole in the middle of a pasta spoon is only there to drain hot water when you dish your spaghetti out of the pot. But its intended purpose starts before you even put the pasta in the water. If you fill this hole with dry spaghetti, it'll be the exact amount for a single portion. Here's another trick you can try. Cover the mirror in your bathroom, or at least a face-sized part of it, with a thin layer of toothpaste and wipe it off. If you take a hot shower, the mirror won't fog up. It'll work with your car mirrors too. While you have that toothpaste in your hand, Check out those weird markings on the bottom of the tube. For a while, people thought these marks meant something about the ingredients in the toothpaste, but they're actually there for the factory's robots. They mark the line for a machine to know where to cut and fold a tube. There's nothing worse than a big itchy mosquito bite, especially when you don't have any cream to put on it. Forgot to pack that too? Maybe camping isn't your forte. Anyway, no worries, just spread some stick deodorant on the bite. Deodorants have a cooling effect when they dry, and it helps ease the itching. If you have no deodorant with you, pew! I mean, you can also use toothpaste, honey, or a cold tea bag. If you have a sore throat, marshmallow can soothe the irritation for a while. The tasty, sweet, puffy stuff won't heal your throat, but it'll help you coat with bitter-tasting remedies. If you accidentally used a permanent marker on a whiteboard, just color over that mark with a whiteboard marker. Wipe the area off, and both marks will be gone. Magic! Snow, especially in the city, is full of different salts. And all these salts end up on our shoes and form ugly white stains that are so hard to clean off. What's worse, these salt stains will eventually damage leather or any kind of material. Surprisingly enough, you can use lemon juice to clean salt from shoes. Just a spoonful of juice on a cloth will do the trick. Your keyboard is nice and clean thanks to that post-note trick, huh? But have you ever wondered why the keys are placed where they are? Why not use alphabetical order? Well, because that originally proved to be too convenient. Long ago, in the ancient time, before computers, people used these things called, typewriters. How historic. Some typists were so fast that the typewriter's mechanism couldn't keep up with them and would get stuck. That's when they decided to change the order of letters to slow typists down. Keyboards today don't care how fast you can type, but the QWERTY key order has remained the same. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.